feeling successful. I'm getting rid of shit. What is up, my friends? Welcome back to my channel. It's been a hot minute since I've posted a video, and I'm well aware of that. I know. Life happens. It's been grand. It's been great. I'm very, very thankful for where my life has been lately. So I just haven't got to YouTube a lot. But with that being said, I have some really excited announcements to share with you. I feel like I'm just like regurgitating like a bunch of information right now, but basically my boyfriend and I are going to be moving to South Carolina next week. I'm so pumped. You guys have heard me mention it a couple of different times throughout videos, like I'd really like to move, maybe we'll move, that'd be cool if we can move, and it's finally happening. You can see there are some boxes behind me. Redis and I have packed up a good portion of our closet of items that we just didn't think we would use within the next 2 weeks. But then we did laundry and we pretty much filled our closet back up. So it's kind of gotten filled again. I did a closet clean out a couple months ago and you guys loved it. I was very nervous that showing you guys every individual piece would just be too time consuming, too annoying, too drawn out, and you guys seem to really, really like it. So sorry, I did get a message. But anyways, I decided to go ahead and do that again today, but at a more extreme level. And then I also think once we move at the end of next week, and get all of our items out of the boxes and put back into the closet, that I'm going to do yet again another closet clean out. Just because I feel like right now I'm kind of like thinking, what am I gonna wear when I'm in South Carolina? What is the vibe? What's the vibe I want within myself? That kind of thing. And I just kind of packed up some stuff. I did get rid of some stuff, but I also feel like once I'm there, I'm gonna be like, yeah, I'm not gonna wear this. Like, I don't need this in my closet. There's so many other like cool boutiques and thrift shops and things that I could bring in new clothes for this new time in my life. So with that being said, I hope you guys are excited for today's video. I know that was a lengthy intro, but I do appreciate you guys for listening. As always, make sure you thumbs up if you like this video. Leave a comment down below. I love talking to you guys. I love talking to you guys on my last closet cleaning out video. You had so many great tips for me. And subscribe if you haven't already. With all that being said, let's jump into the closet clean out video of half my clothes that's not packed away. A closet overview. Cusco. I feel like I should give you guys a closet overview of kind of what we're working with, just to see where we're starting. Again, please be mindful, I did pack a lot of it away.
But okay, so doing a quick overview of what the closet looks like right now. Up top, you can see Redis got rid of a lot of his jeans and packed them away. We have a couple books up here, but nowhere near the amount of books that we had before. Again, they're packed away. This like random vintage storage container, a pillow, shorts, hats that I need to go through, some jeans, all of my clothes that I left out and did laundry for, some shoes that I need to go through, a vintage wedding dress that my aunt gave me, Cusco stuff, and then of course Redis's stuff.
I think right off the bat, I wanna go ahead and start with hats, because I do have a very unhealthy amount of hats that I don't wear a ton. I do usually wear a ball cap or a sun hat when I'm out on the boat, and I do wear a couple of beanies now and again when we're hiking and it's colder out, but I don't need the bucket of hats that I have. So let's go through those first. Also, has anybody seen that Cosmo Wanda TikTok trend? Because literally, this is the box of hats that we're gonna go ahead and go through. Redis got me this when we went to Minnesota last year for Christmas. That's pretty cute, but it's not as like slouchy as I like them, and it makes me feel so bad to get rid of things that have like memories attached to them. I think that's why people hold on to things for so long. This specific memory is kind of comical. We're at a frozen waterfall, insert the picture here, and then there was this brand new small business shop opening up that I had heard about, and I was like, we have to go. So we went to the waterfall, and then we went to go there after, and I had to pee so bad on the way back from the waterfall that like Redis was so insistent, like, we gotta go, you really wanted to go. And I was like, no, I just need to pee. There was no bathroom in the store, unfortunately, so I just kind of ran around super uncomfortable, and then Redis picked this up for me and some bath bombs. And so yeah, it's kind of a comical story, but do I think I'll wear this? I don't know. I like it. I just have so many beanies already. I don't know. What are your thoughts? I feel like it looks pretty with my eyes. We'll put this in the maybe pile. Next up, we have this giant pink sun hat. Genuinely just bought this. I actually posted a photo on my Instagram for Mona Jewelry, which is, again, another small business in Florida. I did a little giveaway with them. Super cute, but it's a little bit too pink for me. It matched my bikini perfectly, but I don't know that I would wear this on an everyday kind of thing. And I have this sun hat, which I much prefer wearing like a straw hat like this for boat days. And this one's pink. I also have another one that's in our garage right now that's yellow and like floral on the bottom that I've loved for years. I've had it since I was in like high school. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and keep this pink one and then that yellow one and get rid of that pink, all pink straw hat. Next up, we have a Breeze beanie. The nicest airline. My boyfriend got this for me, so we're not parting ways with it. This has been deemed my travel beanie, so anytime I'm like traveling, I more or less majority of the time travel Breeze, and I wear this beanie and I always get compliments from the flight crew, so we're keeping that. Next up, I have this World Challenge Ferrelli race beanie. My dad got this for me years ago. We used to go to F1 races and like the IndyCar races, and yeah, this is just, I feel like I have to keep this. Next up, we have this Adidas pink hat. I'm not a pink girl. I don't know why I have so much pink. I'm genuinely not a pink girl. I thrifted this. It's cute. I'm just not a pink girl, so we're gonna part ways with this. I have so many other cool hats that I love. This Carhartt beanie, I love this. I got this last year. This is like my hiking beanie. I have a couple of them, but I really like this one, so I'm gonna keep this one. Next up, I have a lightning beanie, which freaking can't part ways with this. Like, we are the champions, so not gonna part ways with this. So fun. I think my dad also got me this one as well. Next up, we have this, I don't know, like knit headband thing. I've never worn this. I don't think I'll wear this. And it's pink. This vintage Poseidon little hat. I have worn this since high school. This has been like my favorite little train conductor hat. I don't know what you would call this. We're not parting ways. This fits me perfectly. I absolutely love it. This has been like my signature, so we're gonna keep that. Honestly, I think this is Rita's beanie, so I'm not gonna get rid of this. I also have this vintage little Roxy hat that's so cute. I've had this again since high school, and this is like my little beachy hat. It has a little logo there. So cute. My one pair of Mickey ears that I bought, actually Kelsey got these for me when my boyfriend cheated on me a couple years ago. So these are my little Disney lollipop ears. I like to just have one pair and they're my favorite. Next up, we have a Bentleyville beanie. I got this from last year in Minnesota when I went to the Bentleyville lights parade thing. Rita's got this for me and I really like it. As you can tell, I kind of have a style. I like the slouchy with the pom-pom. So I think we're gonna keep this one too. This is really cute for like Christmas. Oh, I've had this one for a really, really long time. This was like my go-to for forever. This is probably like one of my first slouchy pom-pom beanies. I felt like it was such a staple, but genuinely like it's kind of dingy and I have so many other cool ones. I think I'm gonna part ways with it. I love this one. Kelsey and Kyler got me this for Christmas a couple years ago. It's my only Love Your Melon beanie and it's in my favorite color. So cute. Definitely keeping this one. And then we have one more beanie. This one's from Izzy. My dad also got me this one from like some coffee shop. I wanna say in North Carolina. I'm not sure where it was, honestly, but this one's really cute too. So I think we'll keep this one. I have this little sun visor from Adidas. I use this for golfing, so we're gonna keep this. My favorite Columbia hat. I use this for fishing a lot. It's in a bright yellow color. Love that. This is my favorite hiking hat. It's a North Face hat, but it has like a little bear and then like a mountain range on it. Super cool. Again, I use that for hiking. This Carhartt hat. This is cute, but it's not my favorite. So get rid of that. This is my USA hat that I use for 4th of July. And it's kind of been deemed like a tradition that we go out on the boat on 4th of July. So I'm gonna keep this. So I didn't get rid of a ton of hats, but I did get rid of some. So I'm okay with that. Oh, I also forgot I have this Carhartt hat. This fell out of bag. Cute. What's this? Is this mine? This hat. This is the first hat that Ritas ever gave me. It was his favorite hat, and I was giving him shit because he wouldn't let me have it. And it was like, I wore it on our first first date, which was on the boat, but memories. Okay, so next up, we're gonna go through jeans, which genuinely, I'm not like overwhelmed with the amount of pants I have. I feel like I have a good set amount of pants, but I'll go ahead and try them on and go through them with you. So these are the first pair of jeans that I have. They're Levi's, they're pretty standard, like skinny jeans, just a little bit like loose on the foot. But I do like these, so we're gonna keep these. So then we have these jeans, which I'm normally not a fan of lower rise jeans, but these are so unique and fun and cute with the little like carpet rug patchwork details. We definitely have to keep these. These are way, way, way too cool to give up right now. These like nude checkered little pants. These are super fun. These are relatively new and I do really, really like these. So we're gonna keep these too. We have these brown swirly high-waisted jeans. Again, a really fun, funky pattern. I just struggled so hard to get these on because the zipper was broke and then like it was just tight. And I wore these to California recently, but maybe they didn't wash up as well. I don't know. I don't want to take things that I'm not comfortable in. So I'm probably going to sell these on my Mercari and then try to find a similar pair in a bigger size. Next up, we have these black skinny jeans. I don't ever wear these out. I only really got these for a work event that I had, but I feel like I have to keep them in case I have another work event because they are long enough and they are comfortable, so I'm gonna keep these. Then we have these bedazzled like flare pant jeans, and again, they're like a low rise, which I'm not super comfortable with and I don't tend to wear a lot. My mom thrifted these for me. I do think they're cute, but I don't think I'm gonna get a lot of wear out of them, so I'm gonna go ahead and donate these. Okay, then we have these flare pants from Target. And honestly, they were really cute when I first got them, but I feel like they massively shrunk up. Not the best quality, super short. So I'm gonna donate these as well. So I genuinely really like these pants. I think they're a nice quality, but they're so short on me. So we're gonna go ahead and donate these as well. Maybe I can find something of a similar material and fit when we move. All right, we've got another pair of black skinny jeans. I absolutely hate them. They're way too low, they're way too tight, they're way too short. Donating these right away. Flare jeans, they're low-waisted, they're tight, I don't like them. So I've had these for a pretty long time, so I feel okay getting rid of these. All right, so obviously I was not intending to get rid of as many pants as I did, but I'm proud that I tried things on because I did end up getting rid of a lot. So these are all the jeans that I'm getting rid of. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pairs of jeans that I'm gonna donate or sell. And then I ended up just keeping 1, 2, 3, 4 jeans. And then obviously the ones that I'm wearing right now. So that was pretty good. I'm glad I tried those on. Next up, obviously I just changed back into these jeans, but I feel like I should go through shorts while I'm at it. Like that would make sense, right? Yeah. These are the shorts that I've got. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So let's try these on and see if I like them. All right, so these are the first jeans that I tried on. They're like pink vintage little Levi's. Honestly, I thought these are gonna be too small or too short, but I really like them, so I'm pumped that they fit. We're gonna keep them. I have these like patterned pink shorts. I didn't zip them up all the way, honestly. They're very short in the back, and they're not something that I would typically gravitate towards, and I've had them for a little bit and have not worn them, so I'm gonna go ahead and donate these. Next up, we have these black shorts that have like little grommets on them. Honestly, a vibe with what I'm wearing for like a concert, but do I think I would wear it on the daily? No, but it's kind of fun. And I have a couple concerts planned coming up. I'm going to Sleep With Sirens, and then Bad Omens and A Day To Remember. So I think I'm gonna keep these for those shows and then maybe revisit whether I'm gonna get enough use out of them or not. Cause they're still comfy and they're cute and like I can bump around, jump, have fun. So we're gonna keep these. This little vintage denim short number, I think they're really cute and pretty timeless. So I'm gonna go ahead and keep these. I have these black cutoff denim shorts. I got these originally as jeans from my mom and then I cut them off and they're super, super tight and uncomfortable still. I know they're cute, but I am suffocating, so we're gonna donate these. Then we have these blue little Lilly Pulitzer buttercream buttercup shorts, whatever the heck they are. I thrifted these last week, honestly, purely to sell, and I guess I stuck them in my closet thinking I would wear them. They're too low rise, I'm not comfortable, so we're gonna donate slash sell these bright blue shorts. And then lastly, my tried and true little light wash distressed jean shorts from American Eagle. I love these. I probably wear these the most, so we're gonna keep these. These are the shorts that I'm gonna keep. I've got 4 pairs and then 3 pairs that I'm gonna donate. Again, really happy that I tried things on and just didn't go off of like look, because some of those things weren't comfy anymore. So these are what we're keeping. I need to put my hair up. It's getting too hot in here, guys. It's getting too hot. I am so excited to get out of the heat. I know it's still hot in South Carolina, but the humidity here is killing me slowly. All right, so I'm deciding what to do next. So far we've gone through jeans, shorts, hats. We can go through clothes that's like hung up. I just genuinely don't think like I'm gonna get rid of anything because I packed stuff up already. So these are like my favorite and stuff like that. But you know what? You guys like when I pull out my clothes and explain why I'm keeping it versus why I'm giving away. So let's go through. Maybe we'll find a few items that I actually do give away. Starting off, we have a Parkway Drive shirt. I'm not getting rid of this. If you guys have been trying to go to a Parkway Drive show like I have, it's been canceled the past 3 shows, so I'm not getting rid of this. I also have a Day to Remember shirt. I think this is so cool. I went to this show with my parents in St. Augustine. Not getting rid of that, shocker. I actually have kept all of my concert shirts, tour shirts. Not necessarily like shirts that I went to Hot Topic and got, but like band merch shirts. I've kept all of those since I started going to shows so that my kids will think I'm a cool mom and they'll be able to wear like vintage screamo and hardcore shirts. So I'm just not gonna part ways with any of my band merch. Next up, we have fishing shirts, which I pretty much went through these earlier, but I love this one. This is my Huck like zip up one. I love that one. I also really, really love this one. Same style, just in like a pinky coral color. This is like a really pretty blue North Face. This is North Face? I thought this was Columbia. Great. Clearly I've never worn this, but I really like the color. Do we think I'll wear this? I don't like thinking too hard because then I'm like, no, you won't wear it. I don't like this little cinching right here. Like maybe that's why I've never worn it, because typically I get my fishing shirts in like a XL because I like them to like droop over my bikini. Okay, I think we're gonna get rid of this. I'm thinking too hard on it for too long, so. And then we have this one which needs a new hanger anyways, but I do really, really like this one. This one's in just such a pretty like teal blue color. It's like my favorite color, so we're gonna keep this one. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and move into all of my browns and neutral tops. I think I'm just gonna honestly set them right here and go through them. No, I'm not trying on shirts just because like most of these I've already worn within like the past couple of months, so I know like what they look like. So first up, we're not getting rid of this. My best friend Gabby hand knit this for me. This is the coolest thing ever for my birthday. And I absolutely love it. I will link her Etsy down below. She does like really cool knit like bra tops, bikini tops, and then she has like some stickers and some really cool stuff. So definitely keeping this. Check down below for her information. Then we have this little leotard, which is super comfy and I really, really like it. Ooh! The universe said no. Then we have this little racer back nude tank top. I actually wore this in my last closet clean out video and it's just super comfy and easy to lounge in. So we're gonna keep this. This is kind of the same idea, but it has a really cool little like cutout detail. I don't know. And yes, this is from Shein, but I thrifted it. Like I say in all my videos, pretty much everything in my closet is thrifted unless it was gifted or it's like memorabilia from a national park. This shirt, my mom got me this shirt. It's so fun. I've just never worn it and I'm not a fan of this like cinching thing at the waist, so I do think I'm gonna part ways with this. This brown crop top, which is honestly so comfortable and super cute, so keeping this. Famous vintage 100% silk nude button down, keeping this. I love this shirt. I got a lot of wear out of it. I genuinely don't tend to like reach for it anymore. It was kind of like my skater vibe. So I think I'm gonna part ways with this. This shirt matches those checkered nude jeans that I showed you earlier. So I have to keep this. It's the only thing that matches perfectly. This sweater, I wear this all the time. I wear this for a lot of my business meetings over Zoom. So keeping this. This little jacket is really fun. There is a slight stain on the back from when I leaned on some oil in the shed, but honestly really like this and a really timeless piece. So I'm gonna keep this too. This is from my Sequoia trip. I freaking love this. Look at the little pine cone. Isn't that adorable? I love this so much. And I got this in like a large, so it would be like a dress. Keeping this, obviously. We have this sweatshirt that I just thrifted last week. Super fun, like a sleeping bag material. Definitely keeping this. I have this brown shirt that matched those brown swirly pants that don't fit me anymore. I don't know if I would wear this by itself, but I kind of like the brown chocolatey color. I don't know. I think I'm gonna donate this, honestly. I have this shirt, which is like my vintage zebra velour shirt. I like this a lot. I'm keeping it. And then the last brown slash nude top that I have is this like knit little macrame one. My friend got me this from Ross, but it's really cute. So I got it recently. I'm gonna try it and see if I wear it. I think it's fun. So we'll give it a chance. You can't play with clothes while I'm trying to show them, okay? Okay? Okay. Moving on to black and gray tops. So the first one I have is this black, just simple long sleeve. Again, I had this for work. I genuinely don't wear it outside of that. And I have like work expos like once a year. So I'm not gonna keep that. I can always get another one. I really like this accordion sleeve Free People top. I haven't worn it yet, but I want to. this black Nasty Gal one piece, what's this called? A bodysuit. I do like this a lot, but I have another one that I wear a lot more, so we're gonna go ahead and get rid of that. This I just thrifted. I think it's really cute, but I don't know. I'm not a fan of it anymore, so yeah. This is the black bodysuit that I was talking about that I wear a lot more, so we'll keep this. Rita's went to NASA the other week with a friend, and he brought me back this sweatshirt. Obviously gonna keep that. And then my Smokey the Bear t-shirt. Obviously gonna keep that. So wow, we did get rid of some stuff. Next, we're gonna move into white tops, which apparently I really like white tops. The first one I have is this white beaded pearl little bralette. I ordered this online and I genuinely don't like it. It's really heavy, my hair gets caught in it, it's not comfortable. So we're gonna donate this. Next up, I have this little Zara cropped lace top. I do like this a lot. I also have this white vintage tank top, which again, I like a lot. I feel like I get a lot of wear out of it during summer and spring. So even if I haven't necessarily worn it now or since now, like it's gonna get wear. I wore this a ton. I really, really liked this a lot, but I feel like I've overworn it. So I'm gonna go ahead and donate that piece. This is my basic white t-shirt. Everybody needs one. My pumpkin spice shirt. I don't know why I didn't pack this up because I'm obviously not gonna wear this like now, but for fall, yes, we're gonna wear that. My Zara top, you guys know I love this, such a fun and unique piece. This White House Black Market sweater, I feel like it's cute, I don't know. I don't know if I'll wear it though, honestly, so I think I'm gonna donate this. I have my Madewell little top, which I love a lot. Another fishing shirt, this one's new. Do I like this? Yeah, I think I do. Okay, I haven't worn it fishing yet, so we'll see. This like linen little white shirt I love so, so much. This sweatshirt that says a little bit dramatic, I like it a lot too. So we did get rid of some white pieces, but we did keep some. Next, we have oranges and red pieces to go through. First up is this vintage, like tribal bohemian button down. I love this, we're keeping this. I have this red bodysuit, which I wear a ton of. This is the well-known Carolina Girl t-shirt that Reeves told me I had to get because we would move to Carolina one day, and guess what? We're moving, so I feel like I have to keep that. This is a bodysuit that I got from Target. And there was like a Target account that I followed and they posted this and I was like, that'd be so cute tucked into jeans for like Valentine's Day. And then it's extremely see-through. Like there's nothing. So I don't really know how to wear it, but I want to because it's really cute. So I need to think on that one. This to like wear over a bikini. Literally last week, but I'm not really feeling it anymore. So this is why I need to be so much more harsher at making decisions when I'm thrifting. So yeah. Then I thrifted this sweater last week, which I love this so much. My Get Dirty Jeep shirt, keeping that. This is a yellow piece, but that's okay. I've had this since high school. I love this. Orange shirt. It's a Madewell shirt, but I really don't wear it. So I think I'm gonna donate that. And this surf sweatshirt that Rita's got me. I love this. Moving on, we have some pink and we have some yellow. So you're in my spot, sir. Ralph Lauren little like cropped shirt. I love this shirt, I'm keeping this shirt. This, which I think is really cute, but I have not worn it yet. So I don't know. I feel like it's cute, but I don't know that I like the sleeve detail, but I think you can unbutton these and then maybe I'll like it more. Let's see. Oh yeah, you can unbutton them. Okay, we'll give it a chance because you can unbutton them. I went to Disney. I wore a very breezy romper that was completely Marilyn Monroe vibes all day. So I had to get this to tie around my waist. I like it though. This Free People bodysuit, always forget that I have this, but it's so nice on a summery day to just like pop. So we're gonna keep this. Free People little workout tank, just got that, keeping that. A shirt, just got this. I don't know, I think it's fun keeping it. This I've had for a little bit now, but I have to wear it when it's a little bit colder outside. So I'm gonna keep that. The Life is Good little hiking shirt, gonna keep that. Oh boy, I went through a phase where I loved little vintage camis like this. And this one was like my all-time favorite besides one other one that I have in my closet. And I think I'm gonna keep this just to see if I wear it this summer. And if I don't, then I will donate it. Moving on, we've got blue and green tops. This green bodysuit, definitely keeping. This I thought was so fun, but then I did a try on the other day and I didn't like how it looked. So we're gonna get rid of that sweater. This green little silk button down, I love that. My Yosemite sweatshirt, love that. This little top I wore a couple times. Honestly, it was like a BOGO deal and I don't really like it. So we're gonna get rid of that. This top's really fun, gonna keep that. My aunt sent me this. Life is too short, buy the plants. This top I've tried to wear a couple times, but I feel like it's just not cute on me. But I'll try to wear it for like brunch one day and then part ways with it. Cause I feel like I need to get at least like one outfit out of it. My Tallulah Gorge shirt, my Take a Hike shirt. This shirt I think is really cute when it's tied up. This is the other little lace top that I was talking about that I really like. This is really cute. I thrifted this and I've actually worn this recently. This Lily Pulitzer shirt I think is cute, but I just don't think I'm a Lily girl. Like very seldom do I wear a Lilly Pulitzer. It has to be like the perfect piece. So I think I'll probably donate this. Next, we'll go through some little like jumpers or rompers. So I wore this one the other day. This is the one I wore to Disney that I had a ton of Marilyn Monroe vibes with. That just kept flowing too high. I think it's really cute, but genuinely it's an extra small and I'm more like a medium now, so it's not super comfortable. So I'm gonna go ahead and donate that. This is a set and I think this is so cute. I don't know if I'll wear it again, but I'd like to get at least one more use out of this before donating it. My white overalls, I absolutely love. This is like one of my favorite all-time thrifted items. This is my Lilly Pulitzer jumpsuit. It fits perfectly. It's great for like bachelorette parties or baby showers or things like that. So I will keep that. This I've worn a couple times. It's not my favorite. So I think I'll go ahead and donate this, honestly, right? I think I want to donate it. I'm gonna donate it. And then lastly, this yellow romper I recently purchased, so I'm gonna keep that. I'm gonna go through dresses, which I've been on a huge dress kick lately. First one, this black little sundress. I feel like this is a staple. I'm gonna keep this. This one's super fun. It's like cinched up the side, like a little slinky dress, but it's long. So I'm gonna keep that one too. This I thought was the coolest piece when I thrifted it. It's a vintage Guess dress. And it's got like little sparkly, I don't know. I wore this with black Converse like years ago. And I feel like it's super cool, but I've never worn it since. So I think I'm gonna donate this or sell it to one of you guys. I recently thrifted, I love, it's got a square neckline and it's really flattering. Dress I also recently thrifted, it's like a gown, but I thought for like a wedding, it would be really fun to wear. This dress is a little lemon dress. I love it. I haven't worn it yet, but I feel like it's a summer dress. So, you know, summer's around the corner. We'll wear it. I love, it's like a white, ruffly little dress. This dress I have not worn yet. Honestly, it was in the back of my closet and I kind of forgot about it, but I think I'm gonna try to wear it. This I got for a bikini cover up, but it's honestly too short for like a bikini cover up. So I think I'm gonna donate this. It's not, it's kind of what I had in mind, but it's not essentially what I wanted when I tried it on. Also just recently thrifted this, but I don't like the quarter sleeves on it. I know I'm being picky, but I know what I like, so that's okay. This dress I love, I've worn it a ton. It's like a striped, smocked little maxi dress. This dress I have not worn, but I'm gonna wear it to a wedding. It's really pretty. This dress, which is one of my favorite thrifted dresses, it's really cute and super flattering. This dress I just thrifted. I really like it. I can't wait to wear it. This dress my mom gave me, and I feel like it's really cute if it's not too short on me. So I might try to like wear this when we're in Charleston and see how I feel about it. This dress, which again, I kind of forgot about it, so I'm really excited to wear this in Charleston. This dress is cute, but ooh, I don't know. Maybe we'll give it a chance. I feel like it's a little washed out. Like it's a little dingy, but it could be cute. We'll try it. We'll give it a chance. Next up, we have this dress, which is such a fun Free People dress. I've worn this a couple times. Great for summer. We have this dress. I literally bought this at Target a couple days ago because it was on sale for $10, but it says Lucky right here. And I thought this would be really cute for like St. Patrick's Day next year. So I got it. Then we have this dress, which I've worn multiple times. I like this one a lot. This is also a dress that my mom thrifted for me from Anthropology, and or she thrifted it, but it's originally from Anthropology and I really like it. So I'm gonna keep that. This Madewell dress I really like for like running errands or like working from like a coffee shop. So I'm gonna keep those too. All right, and then these are the last couple of miscellaneous items that are in my closet. We'll go ahead and go through these. This is my newest band merch. It's a Miss May I sweatshirt. I got this at their tour that was like a couple weeks ago. Obviously I'm not getting rid of this, and I got it in an XXL, I think. But yeah, a 2XL. My Patagonia, not parting ways with that. My most recent thrifted North Face in my favorite color, not parting ways with that. My Redwoods National Park rain jacket in my favorite color, not parting ways with that. Next up, I have this, which I thrifted, but it's brand new with tags. I think it was originally from Shein, but it's like a Lululemon dupe, and I really like it. Again, it's in a very similar color to my favorite color, so I'm gonna keep this. This vintage spring blazer, I love. I didn't get to wear it this spring, but I still think it's such a unique piece, so I'm gonna keep this. Next up, we have a denim skirt. I don't wear this a ton, but I feel like it's so important to have like a denim skirt, and this one's just like a bongo vintage like denim skirt. So I think I'm gonna keep that just because it's a good staple. Next up, I have this skirt that I recently thrifted from Marshalls. It's so cute. I'm really excited to wear this in the spring. Thrifted these Lilly Pulitzer beach pants that I love because they're not like overly Lilly Pulitzer, if you know what I mean. They're just like a fun green vibe. So really pumped to wear these to the beach. These are my work pants, which I think are really cute. And I honestly would probably wear them out to like brunch or something too, but they're polka dot and they have like a little built-in belt. I really like these and I can see myself wearing them outside of like a work event, so definitely gonna keep those. These pants I thought were so cool when I bought them and I never wore them. They're Patrons of Peace like little flowy pants, but I don't feel like they look cute on me. Maybe I'll see if my mom wants these because these are like right up her alley, so I'll ask her. The Scooby-Doo pajama set with matching socks that I bought from Target or Walmart, and I still have not worn it. But I feel like I would like this, so I'm gonna keep this and like actually make myself wear it. But two more band shirts. I have a Motionless and White band shirt, which is the Graveyard Shift tour, and this was one of my favorite band shirts ever. And then a Hands Like Houses shirt. This was from Warped Tour years ago, so gonna keep this as well. Oh, and then I also have this wedding dress that my aunt gave me. It was a wedding dress she was gonna use and then didn't use. But I don't think I need this hanging in my closet, so I think I'm gonna pack this up in storage, revisit it one day if this is what I wanna wear, and go from there. But it does not need to take up room in my closet. And then lastly, I have two of my snow jackets. So I have my North Face one, which obviously I'm keeping. This is my most prized possession. This was a Christmas gift from Rita's last year, and I freaking love it. I wore it when we were hiking in Minnesota. And then I also have this white one that has like a belt on it that my Aunt Janine passed down to me. So I'm gonna keep this as well because, you know, it's another one. It's another snow jacket. All right, so that was me going through all the clothing in my closet. I'm also gonna go through shoes real quick, but I'm gonna hang up the hangers and then put the clothes that I'm giving away in a bag, and then we'll go through shoes real quick. So now it's time to go through shoes, which honestly, I pretty much 5 out of 7 days a week wear these black little Birks. But I'm gonna go through my shoes just to see if there's anything I wanna get rid of. Obviously, I wanna keep some shoes for special occasions or different events. But let's go ahead and go through them. So obviously, I'm keeping these. These are my go-tos. I have my white Adidas, which I love. I wear these to the airport anytime we travel or like if I'm just like running errands and wanna be comfy. Then I have my hiking boots, which were a Christmas present from Rita's. These are Kodiak. They are my favorite. They are my prized possession. Not gonna get rid of these. Then I have these like slide-on little loafers. I wear these for work events. And then I have these black, really casual little strappy heels. And again, I wear these just like out and about. They're really comfy and easy to wear like with jeans or a dress or whatever. So I'm gonna keep those. These cheetah booties I think are so fun, but I typically tend to wear these a lot more during fall with like a white sweater and some bulky jeans. But like thinking of that outfit makes me really excited. So I wanna keep these for the fall and colder weather. I don't think I'd wear these around summer too much, but I would definitely wear these in fall. Then I have these black booties, which are really cute. They have like a zip down the side. Rita's got me them for Expo, but I ended up wearing these a ton more. But I still think these are really cute and a great staple to have, so I'm gonna keep these. I have these boots. I think these are really fun and would be great for Christmas, but I just don't ever wear them. And I feel like somebody else might really, really appreciate them, so I'm gonna donate those. And then these shoes, which have been my ride or die shoes since high school. I just think they're like the coolest, badass, like, what's her name, Laura Crawfield shoe. But I really don't wear them anymore. I don't like being super, super tall next to Rita, so I'm gonna go ahead and donate these to someone else who will love them way more and give them more love. Next up, I have some more heels. I have these nude little shoes, and I feel like I got these because I had a lot of weddings coming up and everybody's request was like just to wear nude heels. But I haven't been in any weddings lately. I haven't been invited to any weddings lately. And outside of weddings, I really don't wear these shoes. So I think I'm gonna donate these. Also, I thrifted these last week and I love them so much. They've got a square toe. They're like a green snakeskin and they go up the ankle. I adore these. We are keeping these. We've got some more shoes. I have these Tevas that I thrifted. They're in like a bright aqua color, but I've never worn these. So I don't know. I feel like I have a love-hate relationship because I'm like, oh, I want to wear these hiking. Like, these are a great alternative, but I always just wear my hiking boots. So I think I'm gonna part ways with these. But speaking of Tevas, I also have these ones, which have seen better days, but these are white platform strappy sandal Tevas, and I wear these all the time. My friend Logan gave these to me and I just freaking love them. So I'm gonna keep those. My Olakai slippers, Rita's got these for me and my family 1 year for Christmas. We love them. He always wears Olakai, so I'm gonna keep these. They're great. My little moccasins, I love these. I've had these since high school and they're just really fun to jazz up an outfit, especially like in the fall time. Just gonna keep those. And then some more sandals. I have these little like knit woven ones and I wear these a lot to spice up an outfit if it's like a one color dress or one color romper. And then these are my 4th of July Sperry's. They're like patriotic, really cute. I've had these since middle school, I want to say, and I do wear those a lot. So obviously I kept a lot of my shoes. I did get rid of some, but I also have boots to go through, so I'm gonna put these back and then pull out the boots for you guys to see what I keep and what I get rid of. So I also found my fuzzy Crocs, which I love these for like road trips or like the airport travel, whatnot. So I'm keeping these. These are so fun. I love them. You either love Crocs or you hate them. So I have two pairs of Doc Martens. I love these ones. I wear these to concerts a lot. They're like a faded gray black. And then I have these brown ones. You guys saw me thrift them in a recent thrift haul a couple months ago, and I've never worn these. So I think I'm gonna try to sell these. I don't know, I just haven't loved them enough to keep them in my closet. These two pairs of boots, I've had these since high school. I do tend to wear them a lot, but I feel like because I've had them so long, I don't wanna wear them anymore. Is that stupid? Like, I don't know, like I want a new pair of shoes. I don't know. They're still in pretty good condition. I think I'll keep them. I'll keep them and then like come winter decide if there's another pair of black boots that I like better. Super funky and fun. And I had a skirt that matched them, but I really don't see myself wearing these anytime soon. So I'm gonna go ahead and donate these too. Then I have these boots, which I freaking love, and I thought they were the coolest thing ever. They're Alexander Wang, so they're expensive ass boots, but Rita's hates them. Hates them. And I get it, they kind of look like a pirate boot, so I think I'm gonna donate them. I really don't know when I would wear these outside of like Gasparilla, and that's even if I come back to Florida for Gasparilla, so we're gonna donate them. Then I have my rain boots and my cowboy boots. I wear my cowboy boots all the time whenever I go to like little country bars or like little brunch spots. These have been great. And then I love my rain boots. I thrifted these Tory Burch rain boots and I've had them for years and they've always come in clutch. So keeping both of these. And then the last shoes that I have, I thrifted last week, and they are these like platform snakeskin velvet boots. They're fun. They're unique. I'm going to try wearing them and styling them and I'm pumped to see how they look. So I just finished going through my closet. Successfully got rid of some stuff. I'm gonna throw the rest of the shoes that I'm gonna donate in my bag, and then I'll give you a run through of what the closet looks like now. Success, guys, success.
All right, so now I'm gonna give you guys a quick overview of what the closet looks like now. So obviously we have a couple hangers. We got rid of some jeans. We got rid of some shorts, got rid of some hats, actually got rid of some tops and dresses. And then you can see our shoes are down here and over there. So definitely looks a lot better, a lot cleaner. And I'm excited that I actually got rid of some stuff from my closet because I packed most of it up and I figured I'd have to go through this later, which I still will, but it's okay.